Infinite Drone-In can be played as a single-player game, but also provides immersive gameplay with its Twitch extension, bringing your community directly into your game. All viewers can control their own drones even if they don't own the game, though they may decide to help or impede you. Also, the extension allows for votes, like the power-ups you receive. All in all, it's great fun for everyone, or a real pain in the ass, depending on your community. So let's get started. To set up the extension, go to your Twitch dashboard and select Extensions from the menu in the top left. Search for Infinite Drone-In and press Install. Now click on Configure in the pop-up window and follow the link to authorize your extension. This is required to connect the extension to the game client. You will now have to choose a password. Maybe this time you can go a bit crazy and use a password other than password 123. Finally, go to My Extensions, open the Activate drop-down menu and select Set as Overlay 1. Your Twitch account is now ready to go, time to dive into the game's settings. From the main menu, select Twitch. Enter your Twitch username and the extension's password, which absolutely no one will ever find out because it is so unique and you do care about data security because you are a responsible person. Your game and Twitch account are now connected and you can have your viewers join the action. So let's take a closer look at the settings you can customize. First of all, you get to set the time intervals between votes and how long your viewers have time to cast their vote. Just in case you realize their only intent is to f*** your shit up, you might consider extending the intervals a bit. Or just choose to manually trigger votes by pressing V on your keyboard or up on your controller's D-pad. The next section is about how you will be informed about an ongoing voting. To spice things up a bit, you can set this to hidden. You will now be surprised by the result as soon as you encounter it. Or select result if at least you want to receive a quick notification with the winning option. Progress brings up a detailed overview of the ongoing voting. This might be extremely useful if you're trying to convince your community to vote for a specific thing. But in my experience, they won't listen anyway, so... In addition to that, you can select which kind of votes will be triggered. Skill selection will let your community determine what skills you will be rewarded with for your upcoming level up. When the extra monster field is ticked, the next room will have an additional elite monster waiting for you. These are a bit tougher and will be highlighted, so you know what you owe to your community. Room-wide buff or debuff votes affect all opponents in the next room. This one tells a lot about your community. For example, it's possible to make all monsters deal less damage, or they obtain the ability to steal your health points. Special arena votes will make you take a small detour before reaching the next room. These extra arenas can be a chance to regenerate health or offer additional challenges you have to master. Now you're all set up and ready to take on the challenge. We are happy to hear your feedback and looking forward to seeing you stream our game.